Александр Чуревко from Novosibirsk, and he will give us a talk about a simple equation describing brain hemodynamics. Александр Чуревко works in the Lavrentiev Institute of Hydrodynamics there in Novosibirsk, Russia. Александр, please, you can share screen and start your talk. Yes.
I share my screen. All can see my screen or no?
Yes, we see the screen. Yes.
Can I start?
Yes, please begin.
Oh, okay. I will speak to this term, simple equation describing brain hemodynamics, and I am an only speaker. And with this equation of geodynamics, this measure of geodynamics works many, many people. And I speak about this people within my speech. Yes. First of all, the medicine. What with what medicine problem we work. In human brain, there are some abnormalities, vascular abnormalities. There are many abnormalities, but there are two general abnormalities. This is an aneurysm, yes, and the arterial venous malformation. This pathology is very bad. This pathology is very bad because the pathology may imply a hemorrhage. And what is this pathology? First of all, this is an arterial venous malformation. Arterial venous malformation is a pathological connection between vein and arteries without any capillaries. Yes. This is a schematic of this malformation. As this is the angiography of this malformation. This is a crane, and this is a pathology. We can see this pathology because in arterial bed, we have the special contrast, Röntgen contrast. The treatment of this pathology is a surgical, and this is embolization. Selective saline of blood vessel with some special medicine composition. This is a before surgery, we can see this pathology. And this after surgery, we cannot see the blood in this pathology. Another abnormality is a aneurysm, arterial aneurysm. This is a schema of this aneurysm. And this is a treatment way. One way of treatment is embolization or coiling. This mini microspiral coils. And this microspiral embolized this pathology. This is an instrument. And another way is the stent installation. And the stent installation changed the velocity, the blood velocity. And this is a good tool. But there is a problem. What is the problem? When we are near the surgical doing this operation, the patient can have hemorrhage. The schema operation, this catheter, this some pathology. And we develop and study a simple problem, a simple model of blood flow within the pathology, and we wish to use this equation to predict this problem. First part is a measurement. With the measurement work many people. This is a neurosurgical. This Alexander Kancherovich here in Оксана Кончевич participate in our collaboration. This is a portrait of Оксана Кончевич. This is people who work mainly with measurement. What's the measurement device? Measurement device is a combo map device with combo wire sensor. This is a combo wire device, special device for measurement blood flow parameters. This is a tip of a combo wire sensor. It's a very thin sensor, and in tip on this on tip on the sensor, this is a human fig, and this is a sensor. This is a tip sensor. The ultrasonic speed sensor and pressure sensor. This is a screen of this device. This is a velocity profile, and this yellow. This is a pressure profile, and right. This is a pressure profile, not in brain but system pressure. This is a operation room. It's neurosurgical. This patient. This X-ray scanner. And when the neurosurgical doing this operation, he don't look to the this patient, but look on screen. And in the screen, neurosurgeon can see all that doing in the brain. Yes. This, for example, this is a combo wire parameter, small diameter, and the length, approximately 2 meters. And this is a intraoperational screenshot. This is a sensor, this is the tip of the sensor, this embolized arteriovenous malformation, and this is a screenshot of the device. Yes. This sensor, neurosurgical can shift the sensor, as this, for example, the typical operation, and in this screenshot, we can see the positions of this sensor before embolization, during embolization, and after embolization. Yes. Well, this is another way, the full screen of combo map device. And this is a measure the data that we have. This is a noisy data for velocity. For example, velocity is a noisy, very noisy pressure, not so noisy, but noisy. Was the clinical data, but when I use this combo web device, I have two problems. First of all, this when I use this device first time, I don't have any data, and I spent with neurosurgical approximately 1 year to study what can we do for take this data. But another problem is this data is taken as a frequency of on this frequency, and we have a many very big very low data, and when we look to this graphics, this we can't understand what doing companies. Another good investigation is the PV diagram. PV diagram, we some kind of approximately, it's not in really in strong sense first plane, but something approximately for, as a first plane. This velocity, this pressure, excuse me, in this picture, I am a Russian letter. This velocity in meter and second, and then the pressure in the hydrargium millimeter. And because this is a periodical data, we have this cycle. And when I look on this cycle, it's good because we can see more information in this cycle as the information with this graphics.
Yes.
And when I look to this PV diagram, PV chart, I see that there are two different between two type of pathology of AVM, arterial venous malformation and arterial aneurysm. This is a typical picture for in this we have a red and black lines, and the red lines we now ignore red lines because red lines is a numerical approximation. I speak about later. This is a typical picture for arterial venous malformation, and this is a maybe yellow back. This is a birds picture. This is a picture of arterial NV. This is typical. This is a different. Another difference that when we measure the pressure and velocity in artery, we have the diagram.
Well, it appears there's some connection problem.
Yeah, I think he reconnected.
Yes, yes.
But he's muted.
No, I can see him among the speakers, so. For now, looks fine. So if you reconnect, we can.
Yes, but I don't know how many times this look fine. Maybe not long. Oh, yeah. Excuse me. Yes. This. When we have artery, this fast diagram rotate control clockwise, and when we have then in vain it's rotate clockwise. There are two hypotheses why this rotate different. First hypothesis is published in this paper. In this paper, investigate some model of this brain, of the brain, with a porous layer, layer. This layer is a modeled capillaries. And is this model with some, and this model in artery with control clockwise rotation and in vein clockwise rotation. The second hypothesis is because the artery and the vein are quite different things. In artery we have the muscle layer. This layer is active. In the when the heart walk, we have the pulse wave in the arterial bed, and this muscle layer contract in each pulse wave. And in the artery we have not, or in the vein we have not this muscle layer. I, with my PhD student, I study this diagram in silicon tube. We use a computer pump, and we program this computer pump, and we use the result of measurement to program this computer pump. And in silicon tube, we have the rotation of this diagram as in vain. And this is an open question, why is this is a different? Yes. This diagram is very useful for neurosurgeons. Alexander Koncheruchkev write some program. This program analyzes the data of interoperational monitoring in real time. And in operate in and and plot this diagram in real time in operational room, and where this plot this diagram in real time, we can see what the shift into this diagram, what is the perturbation this diagram is good for the additional predictor for neurosurgeons. What about this about the measurement and the medicine? What about the equation? This equation we can see to this equation as the same kind of approximation of our clinical data or regression of our clinical data. These are people who work in this domain, in the domain of regression. Now, these people don't work now, and these people work. This is Yuri Bugay, my student, and Mikhail Shishleinen, our collaborator. What is the what can we speak about this equation? First of all, we study the blood flow is artery is more interesting than the in the vein, as when we have the very noisy data, and the blood flow is vein is not so octal for neurosurgeries in as the blood flow is artery. Oh, Russian words, excuse me. Arterial vessel is a multi-layer structure. This is the endothelial layer, this elastic layer, this the muscular layer. This muscular is this pulsate, and this is a extracellular layer. Yes. And this artery is placed in the brain. Yes, in the parenchyma. And the process of this complex system, the blood flow, the artery wall multilayer, and the parenchyma, the parenchyma is very, very complicated process. And this process are described by a multidimensional system. Well, for is if we want to very good describing, we must use the, for example, Navier-Stokes equation for flow, the and so on. This is a system, complicated system of equation is partial differential. But we can measure and study only the two-dimensional projection of this multidimensional system, the projection of phase space of velocity and pressure plane. The layer is not seen. Yes. Ah, this layer is not seen. Was artery. This is a muscular layer, not seen layer. We can't use the approximation to seen layer. But the mechanism of reaction of muscle wall to the pulse is a local, is this physiologically, because when we have the pulse wave of the flow in the artery, there are some biological sensor on the endothelial layer, and this sensor takes the signal that we have the pulse flow and get the signal to the muscular layer to contract. And the other process controlled by central nervous system is very, very complicated. And is a question, is a projection velocity pressure plane good? Can we take some information from this two-dimensional projection? The answer is a good projection. If we split the pressure and speed to slow variables and fast variables, as we can see, this is a slow variables. This is a medium pressure, medium velocity. This is the amplitude of pressure, amplitude of velocity. And this is a dimensionless fast variables. Blue variables is a slow variables. And this is a fast. Slow variables change approximately minutes. And the fast variables, this is a variables of pulse. Yes, pulse variables. And we write the equations this for these Q and U variables, for fast dimensional variables. This equation, I write this equation in form of Van der Pol equation, and I use the ordinary differential equation, because we wish to use this equation interoperational to predict some bad things and interoperational bad things, and then this equation must be simple. The numerical method for this equation must be fast, and then I use this equation. I test many forms of the equation, but this form is now is I think is a good form. But maybe this A2 and B2 was a good form, but now with Yuri and Mikhail Shishlenin, I improved this equation. It's not changed this general form, but we have this some improving, but I don't speak now about this improvement because it is in the work. Значит, U – это dimensional velocity, Q – dimensional pressure. And for each patient, we determine this coefficient, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 coefficient, use the clinical data. And this epsilon, this is a fixed coefficient, is 1 divided by 100. For this equation, to determine this coefficient, we solve inverse problem. And when I begin study this equation, I solve inverse problem for discretization of this equation, and use the MATLAB toolbox for determine that coefficients. For determine that coefficient, I take the inverse solution in this sense. Now, with Mikhail Shishlenin, we use more sophisticated algorithm, and this algorithm have more good residual. What about approximation clinical data with the equation? This is a quiz. This is a chart for three patients, the typical chart. Black line is the clinical data. Red line is the solution of this equation. Yes. Well, we can see in this chart that in this position, all see my mouse, or can I use the other point device?
Yes. Yes, you can. You can use it.
Excuse me. This is not good position, but now with Mikhail Shishlenin, this is a specialist in to solve incorrect and inverse problem. We don't see this. This we can see the good approximation, but this is a good approximation to take it to training data. Yes. What about the prediction? This is a pressure. This is a time. This 3 minutes, 6 minutes, 9 minutes. This is a mean value for blue, the mean value of velocity. Red, the mean value of pressure. This maximum and minimum for velocity and for pressure. In this interval of time, we have operation of embolization. We train our model on data with 5 second length. Yes. And we predict the behavior and pressure on this length, this second length, 900 length, 5 minutes. And this is a good prediction. And this is this prediction on the velocity and pressure plane. This is A position. Russian. I have many Russian letter on graphics. In this position is a training data. Yes. We train our model. We take the coefficient and we see that the black the interoperation data, a red calculation data is good, approximately is equal. And this is a predictional data. We use our equation to calculate the velocity pressure for this data. In this position, the embolization is this is the end of embolization. We have very low velocity and very noisy data, and this is not so beautiful graphics. And we can speech the normalized equation. This is the equation that we use is invariant within the embolization. We not only train this equation, we can use this equation for prediction. Some mathematical property of the equation, the stability of not based, but automatic translator. We have the stability of the equation on the point of view of initial data. The initial data are forgotten in time interval approximately cardiac cycle. This is a phase plane, this equation. There are some structural stability when we change the coefficient of equation by 2%. This diagram change, but not destroy. And we test this equation of in 77 cases. You know, all this. This is patient. This is a patient. This patient have a different position of measured sensor. And this we study this 77 cases, and in all these cases, the equation work well. And we study the different cases. We use this equation to predict the blood velocity in the venous. This is the artery, A, B in venous, C on sinuses of crane, and D, this is a prediction for elastic siliconic model. This is a laboratory. In all these cases, when we adapt equation for these cases, is equation is good. This good equation, what about the property of this equation? What is property? We can solve this equation numerically, but I think that when you study some equation, nonlinear equation numerically, we take many data, and I won't take some law. Yes. And for when many people doing this some type of equation, the nonlinear equation. This nonlinear, non-Aftanovos equation, right hand depend on the time. We can use the harmonic right hand with the frequency omega and b that the amplitude, and we can look our equation in the black box. Yes. And we test that black box with harmonic signal, and we ask the question: what is the property of the of this box when we test this black box with harmonic signal? That's the first question. As the second question: what is the relation of this property of this equation and the medical property of this pathology? Now I speak about property of this equation. I we have the hypothesis with the in healthy vessel with this equation have the simple dynamics is the left picture, yes, the blue line, this is the right side, and the yellow line is the solution of this equation. And the, when we have thick vessel, we have complex dynamics in the right picture, yes? Blue line is the right side, and the yellow, in the yellow line, we have some not harmonic behavior of the solution of this equation. Вот. And this, what can we study this behavior, behavior of this solution? First technique is a generalized diagram of Nyquist, or Nyquist diagram. Nyquist diagram, this is a very, very old, not very, but very old technique. But this technique, in general, people use for linear system. For linear system, Nyquist diagram describe all this system. And I propose some generalization, little generalization to this diagram, and I named this generalized Nyquist diagram. What is Nyquist diagram? First of all, we fix the amplitude or right side of this right side. Yes. And then we plot in polar coordinate some line. The parameter along the line is a frequency or right side, and the polar coordinate of each point of this line is the amplitude, это здесь radius of this line, for this polar radius, and the fast shift right side of equation versus solution of equation. Well, for generalized, this is in linear case. In non-linear case, we use two line. The blue line is a minimum modulus solution, and the red line is a maximum modulus solution. Oh, this in this picture we interchange this. excuse us, we interchange these two lines. Yes. Oh, for example, if we look this case. We must draw some line, we must look to this two point. With this, this is a fast shift, the polar angle, and this is a green and red. This is amplitude. Вот. This what about real clinical data for the in term of this Nyquist diagram? For example, first patient, this patient have little aneurysm. This patient not affect vaguely affect the blood flow on its vicinity, and we have many this Nyquist diagram. Each Nyquist diagram correspond to fixed amplitude of right height. Right hand of our equation and the coefficient for this equation determined for this patient. And we have a pseudolinear behavior. This more complicated aneurysm. In this situation, we have different Nyquist diagram, yes? And we have the solution not so not harmonical, is a triangle, not sinusoid, but triangle oscillation. And this Giant aneurysm, this aneurysm very, very big change the blood flow. And this situation, we see this very complicated, Nyquist diagram for points for different points of Nyquist diagram, we have different behavior to our solution. For this, for example, very, very complicated. Yes. The complication on Nyquist diagram implies a complication to solution. But on Nyquist diagram, we can look to all solutions in complete. Yes. We study about 300 Nyquist diagram. We analyzed it. And we have this behavior. Nyquist diagram for real percent divide into classes. As amplitude or right sign increase, the diagram move from one class to another in certain order. First, the normal case, divergent case, yes, this is a distance, big distance. Loop case, some loops on the diagram. Gap case, in this diapason, we have not periodical solution of our equation. And this is a break case, some difficult, very complicated. Normal mode oscillator similar to this, if we use not our equation, but equation of linear oscillator. And the look and breaks show the influence of anomalies. Yes. This is, we can look behavior of solution. Yes. This is the result. And, I no speak very slow, but I result for quotient. This is a chain of this perturbation of this diagram, and some quotient when the quotient have not very big or complicated anomalies, this quotient, the nice Nyquist diagram of this quotient. Life in this class. Other way to study our equation and to understand the relation of the equation and the abnormalities is study the resonance curve of this equation. We study this equation, study this resonance curve with my student Yuri Bugay. We use analytical approximation of the equation and use the Galerkin method. Some people speak about the Galerkin method and the as the method of harmonic balance, and this method have many names. You study one-dimensional approximation, two-dimensional, three-dimensional, and we study with Yuri Bugay the approximation with ultra-harmonic, What about, first of all, what about the more simple case? The approximation equations that have only one frequency, but maybe can shift. We have the Russian. This is a amplitude frequency plot. This is fast frequency plot. The typical, this is the typical plots. Yes, this is a for real percent. This is a real percent. Use the real percent data. Horizontal axis. This is frequency of right hand, and this is amplitude of Galerkin approximation of equation. We have this each line correspond to a fixed amplitude of rise trend of equation. We can look this multimodal equation, multimodal solution, yes, in this equation. And we can say when we look different patient, we can see the different phase frequency response. And this is a very interesting picture. We have the patient that this patient have the gamma range within the measurement. And what about this plots? Before the gamma range, we can look this, not in this amplitude frequency plot. And this amplitude frequency plot. But after gamma range, we have what we have. We have the bifurcation of this amplitude frequency plot. And this fast frequency plot is also bifurcation. We can see that this picture can be have the relation with the patient status. And in this picture, we connect the Nyquist diagram and the ultra-harmonic analysis. Type of line, solid line, dotted line, dashed line, is symbolize different Nyquist diagram. Class, normal case, divergent case, loop case. This line symbolizes the patient and the distance. Symbolizes the ratio of the max amplitude of fundamental harmonic and the ultra harmonic of second order. The left picture is a numerical calculation. This is not calculation in not the numerical calculation of full equation with use not Nyquist or not Galerkin approximation. And the right plot is a Galerkin approximation. We can see the quality and quantity and some quality relation. Yes, and this. And this picture is for not second order. No, second order. The third order. We can see good, approximately good relation of this prefix. And we can speak that the Galerkin approximation is simple, but Galerkin approximation take some important information from our equation. And then the last part is the work of Daniil Pashin. I don't work. It is not a result of my work. This is Daniil Pashin, and take photo of Daniil Pashin from Daniil Pashin avatar from WhatsApp. Excuse me, Daniil, if it is not good picture. We have our equation is an equation with the with small coefficient, yes. This type of equation, in this type of equation, when we want study this equation, when the epsilon like limit to zero, we can take some information. For this, Daniil, rewrite this equation or some special form.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Alexander, I want to tell the to warn you that we have 5 minutes to go.
5 minutes. Oh, so okay. Yes. I speak very fast. Yes. Rewrite this equation. Split this equation to fast subsystem, a slow subsystem. And from slow subsystem, extract slow surface of this slow surface. This slow surface is in special space. And then study the projection of this equation on slow surface. And Daniil, look the and we can see that normal vessels, simple dynamics, this is a vessel, the complex dynamics, as a previous study. What in this slow surface there are many singular points. Cases, and Daniil classify the singulars. This is the classification singular poly. This point may be stable on unstable node, saddle, unstable, focus. And when he studied hyperbolic singularity, he take the results. These results that these singularities can classificate the type of pathology. Type of pathology. Is the pathology intact or this pathology after the operation? And that's all. I finished my speech.
All right, thank you. So let's give 2-5 minutes for questions. Yes. So please, whoever have questions, whoever has questions, ask.
Yes.
All right. I don't see at the moment anyone asking question. Let me ask then, if you could go back to the equation where you introduced for the first time the
first
model.
Time. Go, with go, Q. Go. Yes. I go to this equation. Where is my question? One moment.
Yeah, it was.
No.
You passed, I think.
Oh, yes.
Yes. So, so this equation is for the Q pressure.
Yes,
and
for the Q pressure.
U,
this is velocity.
So is it considered in this equation as external force, or is it a function of Q?
Excuse me, I don't understand the question.
Well, so on uh-huh. the left-hand side of this equation, we have variable
yes,
Q.
Yes, this will velocity. Mm-hmm. Yes, this is a pressure, only and, pressure in the equation.
Yes, and on the right side, you have...
This is a velocity. Yes.
So this velocity in this equation, uh-huh. do you assume to be a given function?
Yes.
So it's external function. Force.
Yes, in the given function, And this function we take from the measurements.
From the measurements.
Yes.
And for instance, I just wonder, for instance, could this be assumed to be, for instance, if in fact a pressure could be a linear function of u, but it would its self-sustained oscillations could be actually produced by the forcing function. Could be the case?
One moment. First of all, this equation is the equation for artery. If we use similar equation in vein, we must change the role, change this variables. Yes. First of all, this because we use this form of the equation. This form of the equation. We use this equation. We use this form of the equation because we have in artery fast shift. First of all, change the velocity, and then change the pressure. Yes. In veins, yes. This is a different thing. Yes. What about the equation? I study many type of this equation. I study linear equation for this prediction and different nonlinearity. This is a experimental form of the equation. And study linear equation don't work. Yes. But if we write equation with more higher power, for example, if we add Q four, for example, yes, this equation was be unstable, yes, and when you add the terms with higher power of Q, and when we use the experiment a clinical data for right hand. We have the problem of stability of solution of this equation. What? Have not pseudo
solution. So what you say, so for instance, if we had only linear terms, so without Q2 and Q3 terms in the equation, you would not be able to reproduce so well the
yes.
I see. Thank you. Other questions? Okay. Well, it appears that no one wants to ask questions.
Yes.
All right. Well, then at this point, I think Alexander, for giving a late seminar today also, because in Novosibirsk it's already dinner time, but Alexander kindly responded to our request to put the seminar later so that our Brazilian colleagues could join. Mm-hmm. All right, I thank Alexander. Thank you very much.